In this video, I'm going to talk about addition of vectors and mainly about Chisel's rule. When we talk about Chisel's rule, we talk about addition of consecutive vectors. But what are consecutive vectors? Consecutive vectors are vectors such that the extremity of one is the origin of the other. So in vector AB, the extremity is B. In vector BC, the origin is B. So AB and BC are consecutive vectors. Another example, DE, EF, and FG are consecutive vectors. Now, to add consecutive vectors, we do the following. AB plus BC will give me AC. Here the extremity is B, here the origin is B. So the resulting vector will be composed of the origin of the first and the extremity of the last. The resulting vector in this case is AC. In the second example, DE plus EF plus FG, the origin of the first is D, the extremity of the last is G, so the resulting vector is DG. When we talk about additions of consecutive vectors, we are not talking about the magnitudes of vectors, because the distance from A to B plus the distance from B to C will not give me the distance from A to C. And same thing here, it is something else, it's not the distance. So to illustrate better, here is an example from real life. This is a river, and here there's a boat and going up the river in this direction, and the current of the river is pulling in this direction. So if the boat is going in this direction and the current is pulling in this direction, then the resulting direction of the boat affected by the current will be this one, which is an application of Chisel's rule. Now here, another application, the sum of a vector and its opposite, applying Chisel's rule. Mn is a vector, its opposite is nm. If I apply Chisel's rule, so the origin of the first and the extremity of the last will give me mm. But mm means the origin and the extremity are confounded. If the origin and the extremity are confounded, then the vector is a point. And the magnitude of a point is equal to zero. So a zero vector is a vector having a magnitude equal to zero. It's a vector where the origin and the extremity are confounded, which is a point. Here is another application of Chisel's rule, or we can more specifically say it's the converse of Chisel's rule. So we want to prove this identity, AB plus CD. We need to prove that it is equal to AD plus CB. Since on this side of the equation, I don't have AD, so I can decompose AB. I write it as AD plus DB. Here, this is the extremity, the origin of the second. So the resulting vector is AB. I'm doing the converse of it. And I can decompose CD into CB plus BD. Why CB? Because on the other side I have CB. And why AD here? Because on the other side I have AD. So substituting on this side, in the place of AB, I write AD plus DB. In the place of CD, I write CB plus BD. But if I look here, DB and BD are opposite vectors, so their sum is equal to zero. So they cancel out. I will be left by AD plus CB, which is equal to the other part of the equation. So I have proven my identity.